Welcome to Faith Revival Holiness Synagogue Parish Church. I'm the servant of the Father God and servant Yeshua, prophet and minister M. Jemaise. Let us begin in prayer. Father, help us. Help us to learn to do our best every day and to be a blessing in the earth and not a curse like we see on the top doing to all. We thank you, Father, and we praise you. Amen. All right. Tehillim, that's Psalms. Rum Atah. And you know, Rum is spelled R-U-M, kind of like Rum. It's kind of interesting. And it means exalt you. Exalt you. So the word Rum, or which is spelled R-U-M in Hebrew, is for exalt. And Atah is for you. Okay, Psalms, the book of Psalms, chapter 31 through 12 and 31, 1 through 24, 1 through 24 of 31, 1 through 12 of 30 of Psalms. Amen. Let us begin. I will exalt you, Yah, because you draw me. You didn't let my enemies rejoice over me. Yah, my God, I cry out to you. You provide healing for me. He provides healing for us. Amen. You provide healing for us. Yah, you lift me up from Sheol. You keep me alive when I sink into the pit. That's what Sheol is. Yeah. Sing praises to Yah, you faithful of His, the faithful of Yeshua Shaddai. Amen. And give thanks and recall Yeshua Shaddai's holiness. For Yeshua Shaddai's anger is the moment, but His favor lasts for lifetime. Tear my linen for the night, but with the draw comes the cries of joy. Sing praises to Yah, you faithful of Yeshua Shaddai's. Give thanks, recall on Yeshua Shaddai's holiness. Yeshua Shaddai's anger is for a moment, but Yeshua Shaddai's favor lasts a lifetime. Tears of leaning that night, but withdrawal comes cries of joy. Once I was pernicious and used to say that nothing could ever shake me. And when you show me favor, Yah, I was firm as a mighty mountain. But when you hid your face, I was struck with terror. So you want to seek His face. Amen. It says that elsewhere. Seek the face of God. I call to you, O Yah. To Yah I plead my mercies. What advance is there in my death? Am I going down to the pit? Can dust praise you? Can it proclaim your truth? You got to answer these things when there's question marks. Can dust praise you? The answer is no. Not like things that are living, even though there could be some organisms in there and dust and things naturally, but because everything has some form of life, basics of life, we should say, not the advancement of life. Like we could say like an animal or other, the most advanced of life, the image and likeness that we have as human beings on this earth. Hear me, Yah. Show me your favor. Yah, be my helper. You turn my mourning into dancing. God wants to turn your mourning into dancing. We got to get our hearts right with Him, right? You remove my sackcloth. Clothe me in joy. God wants to clothe you in some joy today. He wants to remove that sackcloth of sadness and put that holy joy in you so that you can do great things for your fellow brothers and sisters, and God gets the glory for it. So that my well-being can praise you and not be silent. Yeah, my God, I will thank you forever. And you, yeah, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Turn your ears towards me. Come quickly to my rescue. Be for me a rock of strength, a fortress to keep me safe. Sincerely, you are my rock and my fortress. And that's where Yeshua talks about the house that was built on the sand and the rock. And so that goes, ties in with this here. Sincerely, you are my rock and my fortress. Lead me, guide me for your name's sake, Hashem. Free me from the net and they have hidden to catch me, because you are my strength. Into your hands I commit my spirit. You will redeem me, yeah, God of truth. God of truth, amen. I hate those who serve worthless idols. As for me, I trust in Yah. I will rejoice in your grace, in the grace of Yeshua, HaMashiach, amen. For he sees my affliction for you. Yeshua Shaddai sees my afflictions. You know how distressed I am. You did not hand me over to my enemies. Yeshua Shaddai did not hand you over to your enemies to have defeat met. But maybe it's a learning curve. Maybe he's going to arrest you at the last moment. He always does. Look with Jonah and the whale and that basking shark. That was. They thought it was a whale because they didn't know that they didn't have the spounding of understanding like we did today. But you can understand when it says fish over there and it says whale over there, you're talking about something like that's big, right? You're talking about something that lives in the Mediterranean. Well, basking sharks live in the Mediterranean too. And they're big and they look similar to a whale, but they're not, they're sharks. But they're capable of still doing what they need to do. Amen. Some people think it's a sperm whale. That's fine. But do sperm whales are in the Mediterranean like a basking shark? That's all I have to ask on that one. I will rejoice and be glad in your grace. For you see my affliction. You know how distressed I am. You did not hand me over to my enemies. You see, you set my feet where I can move freely. Show me favor, yeah, for I am in trouble. My eyes grow dim and with anger. My soul and my body as well. For my life is worn out with sorrow. And my ears with sight. My strength gives out under my guilt. And my bones are wasting away. I am scorned by all my adversaries, and even more by my neighbors, even acquaintance, and I am an object of fear. But it doesn't stop there, my friends. When they see me in the streets, and they turn away from me like a dead man, or it could be a dead woman too, I pass them from their minds, and I have become like a broken pot. All I hear is whispers. Terror is all around me. They plot against me. That sounds like the politicians, unfortunately, today, doesn't it? Scheming to take my life. That's what they do. That's what they do. We need to pray the judgment on these characters on the top. They're doing these things. But I trust in Yah. I say, you are my God, Emmanuel, our Father God. Many times are in your hands. Rescue me from my enemy's power. from those who persecute me. Make your face shine in your servant. In the, your grace, in the Yeshua Shaddai's grace, save me. Yah, don't let me be put to shame, for I have called on you. This is good rap lyrics for people that are gospel rappers, by the way. Let them be silent in Shiloh. Let the wicked be put to shame. May they lay lips be struck down and speak in solidarity against the wicked. Those that speak against, let them be put to shame with such pride and arrogance. But oh, how great is your goodness. Oh, how great is the goodness. How great is the goodness. Amen. Get that deep into how great is the goodness of the Father. How great is the goodness of Yeshua Shaddai. Amen. Which you have stored up for those who reverent you. Who's the you after God? That's going to be, of course, Yeshua Shaddai. Which you have stored up for those who reverent Yeshua Shaddai. What you do for those who take refuge in Yeshua Shaddai. Before people's very eyes, in the shelter of your presence, Shekinah, another thing that is described who the Shekinah is. And in the Gospels, because it says the Shekinah of God went into Mary and became Yeshua. That's Shekinah is describing Yeshua, because he's the presence of God. Amen. He's the very presence of God. The will, the presence, many different mechanics of what he really is. Amen. That the personal side that comes out of the Father God, the Spirit of God, the presence of God, the Emmanuel, God is with us, all pointing to the Spirit of God in those words, whether you know it or not. You look at them and you take the religious and man-made ideas and woman-made ideas that you had for a thousand years were off of you, and you realize that he's the Spirit of God, because everything that surrounds about the titleships of Yeshua is the Spirit of God screaming about the Spirit of God. He is the Spirit of God. That's why it says there's one God, one Spirit of all. That's Yeshua. That's the Father God. Amen. And the way is another way of seeing the body. Because we're part of the way now of the Father, because the will of God is directing us. That's Yeshua. Amen. That doesn't mean we don't have a will. We do. But our will is corrupted. God's will is not. The Spirit of God, the will of God, the Messiah, is not corrupted. And so he helps us and sanctifies those things so that we can, the will of who he is shows us the ways of the Father. So we're pleasing to the Father now because we have the will of God in us. You know, it's one thing to be born again, but it's another thing to have to be spirit filled with Yeshua. And that's encouraged throughout Scripture, by the way. Amen. That's why there's wise versions and unwise versions, because the unwise versions were born again but not spirit filled with Yeshua, and the wise versions were not only born again but they're spirit filled, so they knew when the shepherd called. Amen. That's the whole concept of that, that is forgotten. But don't let it be forgotten in you. Amen. But oh, how great is the goodness which you have stored up for those who reverent Yeshua Shaddai, which you do for those who take refuge in Yeshua Shaddai, before the people's very eyes in the shelter of the presence, the Shekinah. That's Yeshua, the presence. You hide them from human plots. That's a pretty powerful statement right there. You hide them from human plots, and you conceal them in your shelter. And when you think conceal them in your shelter, well, what a greater shelter than what the cross represents, that his blood came down to sanctify us and take us from the original sin that Adam and Eve committed to being part of that tree of life system now, the new nature of his nature. Amen. You conceal them in your shelter. Amen. Safe from the confertile tongues. Blessed be Yah. For Yeshua Shaddai has shown me his amazing grace. I mean, can you show any more amazing grace than the walk that he showed us to walk and showed the fulfillment of doing all the things of the Torah and the prophets, not in the fleshly way like they knew in the past, but in the spiritual way that we're actually supposed to do it. That has much more meaning, and he shows us daily because we need to be washed clean every day by the sanctification of what he did every day afresh. For Yeshua Shaddai has shown me his amazing grace. And when I was in the city under siege, as for me, in my alarm, I said, I've been cut off from your sight. Nevertheless, you heard my pleads. Nevertheless, God Almighty, the Father, and Yeshua, our Savior, hears our pleads. And when we cry out to Yeshua Shaddai, amen, love Yah, you faithful of his. Play on the fact of after God, that Yeshua Shaddai, amen. Love God, you faithful of Yeshua Shaddai. Yah presents the loyal, but the proud he repays in full. Be strong, filled with your hearts with encouragement. You got to fill your hearts with encouragement. Do you fill your hearts with encouragement of knowing what both the Father and our Savior both did for us, Yeshua, every day? I hope so. And all you who hope in Yah, it's not enough to have faith. You got to have hope in Yah, the Father, what he's done through the Savior, Yeshua, our Emmanuel, Shekinah, El Shaddai. Amen. So we got to fill our hearts with shalom, encouragement. Amen. We got to exalt God and say, yes, we remember. Remember, you are going to take care of us, even though it looks real wild out there. Even though it looks dim. But God is our light and our fortress in whom we will trust no matter what situation, good, bad, or ugly. We all want the good. We got to let that goodness, if we want it to be good again. If you want America to be good, you want Canada or Mexico to be good again, you got to let the goodness out of you, because goodness overcomes evil every time. It's not enough to acknowledge that God has made us good. We got to be doers of that and let that goodness out, and goodness will overcome the evil that they're doing every time. Every time. But we have to decide we are going to let the goodness out of us. Each one of us have to decide we're going to let the goodness out. We're going to let God's talents that God has placed in each of us, out of us, so we can be a society of greatness that we all are, whether we know it or not. Sometimes God has got to shake the fig tree. Sometimes God's got to shake the olive tree that we are. He has to shake us and prune us and say, you know what? You're going to be a good olive tree and a good fig tree, and you're going to have lots of figs and lots of olives, and you're going to grow, and you're going to be, and my anointing is going to come out of those olive trees, and my greatness that I have for you is going to come out of those victories for you every day. We got to see ourselves not as we are, but as what we become through what the Father sees us and the greatness and the fullness of what He does. Never see us in our falters. He sees what we could become. He shows that through Yeshua when He was in the earth suit and how He dealt with all those character politicians of that day that were trying to put the women folks down and the men and everything of that day. And Yeshua put the politicians in their place there. How much greater does He want to put the politicians that are not right in their place, that are hurting all of you today? Fill in the blanks in your own heart on that. Let that be your homework assignment. Fill the blank of that question in your heart, in your mind today. How much greater does He want to help humanity of today that's being abused by all the politicians on all sides? There's good ones out there, yes. And usually are the smaller towns, mayors, that should become greater. They should be the ones that go into the greater things now. Because they're the ones that are the real heroes. These little characters at state and federal level, they've lost their step. They need to look on the small guys and ladies, their mayors, the small towns and the officials. Those are the real heroes that need to be replacing all these phony balonies in the state and federal level. Amen. Because they've been right there thick and thin. They might not always do it, maybe exactly right, because they're human beings, but they're trying their best. They're putting their best foot over. But if people would only share what needs to be done a little bit better, then they would know a little bit better what needs to be done. So it's not, when they do a little fault, when the little politicians do a little fault, it's only the error of the people, because the people are not given their thoughts of their town, of things of improvement, or things that they need to look at. So really, it's the people's fault when it comes down to that. Because their hearts are right, it's just that they need a little input, a little more. Remember what John F. Kennedy said, don't think what your nation can do for you, but what you can do for your nation. That applies. And fill in the blanks of whatever level you're at. It can apply in the town. Don't think of what your town can do for you. Think of what you can do for your town, your input of love for one another, and making the town a very beautiful place. It already is, but you need to see it as that and not see small-minded about things. And you go forth in that greatness, and it becomes that much greater. Because God sees it fully fledged in beauty, and the people's hearts healed and minds healed from the things that have been going on. Amen. God bless you. Now I want to pray for those that have not accepted Yeshua as their Savior and been born again yet, and then spirit-filled with Yeshua. Those that are not spirit-filled with Yeshua need to pray this prayer as well. That's most people, because they have not been trained of understanding about that second half of salvation, being born again and then spirit filled with Yeshua. That's why He's called Emmanuel. God is always with us. He's Emmanuel. He's the Spirit of God. He's with us wherever we go. He's all present, just like God is, the Father. The Spirit of God, the Messiah, is all present. He could be in heavenly places at the same time, ministering right to each one of us. It's something we can't wrap our mind. This is why He's God, the titleship of God, but not the actual name. Yeah, and Yeshua, the Spirit of God. There's God, the Father, and then there's the Spirit of God, which is Yeshua. Amen. Let's get that correct. But they're both two parts of the coin. There's two parts of the coin, the head and the tail, right? That makes it a coin. We don't look at one side greater than the other because it's a coin. Both sides are equal in every way. when you look at a coin, right, and you see the a quarter, you see the eagle on the back, you see the our first president of the Constitution, Washington, on the front. You see that, and whatever country you're in, you see both sides. Some people don't have great memory on their coins, and some do. But it's not about that. It's about the fact the coin has two sides in it. And that's the same thing with the Father God and the Spirit of God, which is the Messiah, Yeshua, and the Father God being the Father over all creation, everything. And his sacred name is Yah, it's not Lord. We don't serve Baal. We serve Yah. And as far as what it said, the better translation is Master Yeshua, not Lord Yeshua. He's not Baal. This is why it says in the last days, people will say, Lord, Lord, which means Baal, Baal, Baal. We come in your name. No, he didn't come in his name. He came into a foreign god, Baal. Not Yeshua. This is why it says in the New Testament, go by his name. His name is Yeshua Jesus, so go by that. Amen. And everything titles after that, but be careful. It's got to be a little more careful. This is the Spirit of God we're talking, the Messiah. We need to be careful of those things. Same with the Father God. We got to be careful. And the sanctity of their names, we go by. And when Moses was revealed about Yahweh, it represents both of their names together, because you can tell from the first part is Yah, that's the Father's name. That means power connected to all things. The Vahat, which means, or Wahavah, means the light source, because Yeshua is the light source. He's the lighthouse. He's the power behind the power of God, amen, himself, amen. And they are both the coin, even though it has two sides. And that's the way you look at it. It's two sides of the coin. There's a lot of things that with two sides of everything. It's just mankind has three because of the fallen nature. The flesh is the fallen nature. Originally, Adam and Eve had a super soul and a spirit form. And when the spirit and the form separated, the form became carnal flesh, the spirit dead into the family of God, and Yeshua brought us full circle on the cross. And now we understand what family is. We're family with God fully. And now we understand about the sanctity of our spirit and how some of it's missing, and it's far like a gate far away, the form. But in Romans chapter 12, 8, it says that we'll be renewed in those things, that we'll have a spirit form and a super soul again that's unlimited. So, where our souls are limited in things, it'll be unlimited in our glorified body. Amen. So, let's pray this prayer. Dear Father God, to pray, dear Father God, thank you for Yeshua. Thank you for sending El Shaddai and put him in an earth suit as Yeshua, Yah salvation. We understand he's your salvation he's given. That's your heart. This is why Yeshua said he took your name, Yah, and Shua meaning salvation. That's why he took a lot of people. I pray a lot of people read this thought by thought and not just verse by verse, because you'll never get the fullness just of what is really being said. And so, Father, I pray right now as they pray this prayer to say, thank you, Yeshua, for dying on the cross for me. Thank you, Yeshua, for living a perfect life for me. Thank you, Yeshua, that now I'm going to be born again and your salvation is going to be mine. Thank you, Yeshua, that I'm going to be not only born again, but spirit-filled with you. And we thank you, Yeshua, for everything. Thank you, Father. You're so perfect in all your ways. This was your heart and plan from the beginning. Everything was written in Genesis to Revelations of Yeshua. Amen. We thank you and praise you. Welcome to Family God. You know, now just get yourself a Geneva Bible, a complete Jewish Bible, or a Tree of Life version Bible, and start reading it. I would start in John. John, the Gospel of John, and then the first epistle of John, which is found down the line. Start there on those two books. And just read it, read it, read it. No hurry. There's no hurry, you know, on that. And when you feel comfortable, the next level of reading I want you to do is Proverbs and Psalms. Just read the Proverbs and Psalms. And just read that, read that, read that, read that. And then I want you to four epistles of Paul. All right? The four epistles of Paul. Ephesians, Philippians, Galatians, and Colossians. Those are the four epistles of Paul wrote. Read that real good, you know. And read the book of Jude with that as well. Amen. And then after that, I want you to read Deuteronomy. And I want you to read 1st and 2nd Peter with that to level those things off. Amen. And then after that, you start looking at the smaller writings of the prophets. Just go through them. Take your time. Amen. After that, then I want you to read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Matthew, Luke, and Mark. All right. And then go back. And I want you to take a look of Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Ezekiel. Amen. And you're going to be really equipped. From there, you're going to fill in the gaps where different things are in the Bible. Amen. Because you'll be really ready for a lot of things. But if you follow this pattern, you start in John and the first epistle of John, you know, it's going to start you in the right path. Because everything you need is in John to get you started. It's really in John and epistle of John, sorry. Amen. So, Father, I pray over them. May your shalom be with them. May your kadova of honor and righteousness. And we thank you, Father, and we praise you, Father. Thank you, Yeshua. We're so privileged to have you in our life every day and strengthening us and making us into that glorious man or woman you called us to be, even children. Amen. They're growing up and under their guardians, their parents. And we thank you, Father, and we praise you, Father, for all things. In your holy name, Yeshua. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Holiness that brings peace that passes all understanding. None of us have a number of it. Complete peace be with you. Shalom to you. God bless. Keep in there. Don't get sad when you can get some of the deliverance of joy, the anointing of joy. Of oil. Anoint yourself with oil. The oil represents joy, a deliverance, the joy of deliverance. It gives you soundness and healing. Amen. God bless. Amen. Let the goodness out of you.